Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to show you how to construct a truth table when you have three statements. Whenever you have three statements, you're going to have eight different lines or rows in your truth table because 2 to the third power is 8. So there's 8 different outcomes when you look at these. And so in this example, we're saying I study hard and ace the final, or I fail the course. First, you need to represent each of the statements symbolically. So for P, for I study hard, I'm calling that P. Ace the final is Q, and then R is I fail the course. So those are the three different statements kind of that I have going on in there. And I'm going to write that in symbolic form. In the first half, I'm saying and. I study hard and ace the final. So in this case, I'm studying hard and I'm acing the final. And then I'm saying or. And then or R, and R is I fail the course. So I can study hard and ace the final, or I can fail the course. That's writing that symbolically. And then I want to complete the truth table. And so I need each part in there. So we start off with we need the P, the Q, and the R because those are our three statements. Then we need to build our truth table, P and Q, and then continue building. Now we have P, N, Q, or R. And it could be that you have 4 different columns needed to complete that truth table. If you negated some of those things, you'd have to put the negations in. So this is definitely not exhaustive. This is just this particular example. The way these truth tables are going to work is that for P, I'm going to put T in the first 4 columns because there's 8 outcomes. 4 times true, and then 4 times false. Then for Q, I'm going to put 2 truths followed by 2 falses. This is a pattern. You can just know this pattern. The last thing I'm going to do is follow up with R, putting true and false alternating. What does that do? Look in the first one. It says if P, Q, and R are all true. In the second row, true, true, followed by false. True, false, followed by true. True, followed by 2 falses. And there's 8 different outcomes. Each of them are different in the order anyway. There might be 2 truths and 1 false, but they don't come in the exact same order in any row. And finally, down here, you can see that we get to all falses. So this is the pattern. 4 and 4, 2 and 2, and then 1 and 1. And now we build our truth table column P and Q. In P and Q, in order for this to be true, both P and Q have to be true. So I'm looking at the first 2 columns, and if those are both true, then I put a true. And I can see that they're both true here. But in the third column, I have true followed by false. If one of them is false, then the whole thing is false. And then true, false again. And then false, true. Still, one of those is false, false, true. One of those is false, false, false. They're both false. And finally, they're both false again. So in an and statement, the only time that you can get a true statement is if both parts are true. So if you have one of them being false or both of them being false, then you're going to get a false statement. Finally, I'm going to take this and combine it with R. And this is an or statement. And in an or statement, if one of them is true, then you can make it true. The only time you'd have false is if they are both false. So all we need to make sure is that one of them is true, because it could be this one or that one, not both. It can be both, but it doesn't have to be both. Okay, so the first one, I'm looking at these 2 columns. And if you had a statement that had a different kind of symbol, it might really be important that you look at those in the right order. But for us, we don't care which one is true and which one is false. We just want to know, are they both true or are they both false? So R and PQ. So they're both true. That makes that true. One of them is true, then it's true. One of them is true. Here's one where they're both false. This is false and this is false. So that's false. And again, one of them is true. Both false. One of them is true. and both false. So my final truth values for that are true, 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 false, true, false, true, false. And so this question at the bottom says, suppose that you study hard, you do not ace the final, and you fail the course. You do study hard, you do not ace the final, and you do fail the course. So in this case, you study hard, that's got to be one of these true statements. You do not ace the final, that's going to be one of these false statements, so I know it's one of these two rows. And you fail the course. True, I failed the course. I did study hard, I did not ace the final, but I did fail the course, and I did fail the course. Under these conditions, is the compound statement true or false? We look to the end here where we have the compound statement and we see that it's true. Okay, you either did one or the other, so that's considered a true statement. We were looking for the case where the first statement's true, the second is false, and the third is true. So that was the third row. All right, and the truth value for that third row is true. So that's how you can read a truth table. That's how you can build a truth table. You need to do that for your fourth part of your logic packet. Have a fantastic day.